Hello everyone, how's everything? You watching with two? I'm doing with two. Let's get on today's video session. Here we go. So this is it. The most amazing gaming systems ever. After this. Okay guys, this is it! Time has come! One of the most amazing 5 games consoles ever made with the games you ever see on any system. Are you ready for this today? Top 5 machines, what can there be in my list? Could you imagine? This is it, Kuma! We need your help! What's the best games console ever made for gaming? Capcom was just a K2-year-old. Nintendo GameCube. Sourced. Carry me this system of the moon. Cool. That's it now. This is it. The most 5 the most 5 games console ever made with one of the most amazing games ever on these systems. Yeah? So, are you ready? This is it. Can there be old systems or can there be any new ones that can top to be number one in this list? This is a serious list, you know. It's not a list that I'm just bringing any machine up and, oh yeah, let's go and just make any machine number one. It doesn't have to be a new machine has to be number one. No, no, no. He was looking at how Nintendo has been making these machines, but none of them was making any impact on the gaming. But they were just based on features, weren't they? The gaming was like getting like a bit downgraded on them. Yeah. So here we go. Number five. Is SNK Neo Geo AES. Yes, it's got into the list. Can you imagine that? Why did it get into the list? Okay, SNK has made arcade cabinets back in the 1990s, and these arcade cabinets were so well respected for their games. No joke. Well, they're very, very well respected, and these titles were really, really massive. Each time they used to come in the arcades, and the arcade cabinets are really, really impressive indeed. So we're not just bringing any arcade cabinets out there, because the reason for this is that when SNK made this arcade cabinet, he thought about idea. Why don't we make a games console on there? That's never happened in the world of gaming, isn't it? This SNK Neo Geo AES was built on their arcade cabinet. Is made on that. You see, if you look at the arcade cabinets, every arcade cabinet game was 2-player, and every game on the SNK Neo Geo was 2-player as well. Yeah, it's a 2-player. And this system was based on the arcade cabinets. Proper arcade hardware in the system. Yeah, that's why it was really, really expensive, because it was based on the original arcade cabinets. They made games like Art of Fighting, King of Fighters, Fatal Fury, Samurai Shodown, and they had few shooters like Blazing Star, Polestar, Metal Slug series. They brought us stuff like that, you know, on this system. So there were some good tiles on this. So there you go. It's at number five. Excellent games console, isn't it? There you go. Number four. What do you think it is in my list? Pretty impressive, this one, isn't it? Number four. Sega Dreamcast. Sega Dreamcast. It's at number four. Yeah. Now, you're probably thinking, of why didn't he go all the way to the top three? The reason for that is that I felt that it was an advanced system, yeah? It was under 28-bit CD-based system, yeah? It was internet access and online gaming, yeah. He had all that. That's fine. But quite a lot of the games they produced, they were either boring or there wasn't much more than them, and sequels. There wasn't much originality in this system, really. I don't think there was, really. The only games I can see in terms of originality is just Soul Calibur. Now, if we look at all the fighting games, there's not that many good fighting games on this machine. No, there isn't. There aren't any. There aren't many good fighting games on there, really. They're just based on sequels, yeah? The only two games that shined on there was Daylight 2 and Soul Calibur. Obviously, Daylight 2 wasn't good as Soul Calibur, so Soul Calibur, Resident Evil Code Veronica, that was a good adventure game. Survivor, however you want to call it. We had Metropolis Street Racer. I don't know. There's not that many racing games on this machine as well. In my point of view, because like it's got Metropolis Street Racer and Sega Rally 2 and Daytona USA. These are the main games that it had, really, didn't it? Vanishing Point as well. If we look at Metropolis Street Racer, it's really difficult. It's too difficult. It's very, very hard, man. Doing all these kudos. It's too difficult, the game is. And then they had this game called Sega Rally 2, 10 year. Like you have to complete each year. It's too difficult. It's too difficult for a rally game. Far too hard. It gets really boring really quickly. Repetitive. Daytona USA is one of the arcade system games. I mean, they released that, but I don't know what to say about it really, to be honest. Because like they released it and it wasn't that amazing the way I'm looking at it. It's a bit of fun, the game is. The Daytona USA. Yeah. Then the same developer did release a game called Ferrari F355 Challenge. You have to master that damn game. It's just impossible to play without mastering the damn game. It's too difficult. Far too difficult, man. Vanishing Point. It was one of the more difficult side-out game that was. If you can't control these cars, you're gonna find this game very, very difficult to play, man. Because what happens in this game, you have to drive really, really fast and it's like crazy high speeds. But the problem is, you can't bank on the side and you can't bank into the cars. They go boom, they're right up in the air and all that. And it messes up the whole damn race, man. It's just terrible the way it was made. So there was racing games like that. I mean, what racing game would I recommend on that? It's quite difficult to recommend some racing on this thing, isn't it? Maybe just Sega Rally 2. It's a bit easier than the other games. You can enjoy a bit more than the other games, I would say. But the problem with Metropolis Street Racer, if you're not good with the kudos, you can't play this game. Yeah. It'd be just impossible to play. The more you progress, the more difficult the cars are in this game, yeah. It's just impossible to blame on. Well, yeah, Sega Rally 2. I think Sega Rally 2 and Daytona USA will be the games that can be played a bit, yeah. These are two racing games. What else was in the Dreamcast? So there was quality games like that. Also, you had Crazy Taxi 1 and 2. That game is too hard. It's up. Flipping time in there, man. It's got all these kind of weird racing games on there. Yeah, they're good, but then we had some more games like... we had games like we had platformers on there. There's not many platformers on this system, I would say. It's only just Sonic Adventure 1 and 2 on there. Too worth playing. There's nothing else worth really playing for platforming on this system, to be honest. Sonic Adventure 2, you had all that in there, yeah. It's a pretty good game. There was quite a lot of improvements when it came on the Nintendo GameCube. Nintendo GameCube version was a far better version of this game. But Sonic Adventure on the Sega Dreamcast was a quite good game, I would say. And Sonic Adventure 2 was a quite improvement over it. Then we had games like Shenmue 1 and 2. Shenmue 1 was too much exploring, adventuring, man. It bores you. You keep on talking to people too much, man. It's too much of it, man. It's just crazy. Just it's nothing. There's not much and much action or martial arts in the game. Yeah, there's not much or fighting in there. It's just like you're exploring around. Then the Shenmue 2, which was a longer game. Yeah, a bit more fighting game. But still, the game just looked like the first Shenmue, but it was a better game than the first one. But still, I think there was some problems with this game as well. It wasn't totally enjoyable because it's still Shenmue, I suppose. But yeah, it was a better game, I suppose. So that's Dreamcast for you. Before we go to the next system, after this, what can be number 3? So after this music, will we continue what we were talking about? As Kuma says. So yeah, number three, what can it be? Nintendo 64. Number three is Nintendo 64. Now, Nintendo 64 had some quality games, I would say. It was a proper 3D-based system. It was a 64-bit cartridge-based system. It was really, really impressive in every way. But there was too many games from Rare. That's what I didn't like about this thing. Yeah. There were too many stuff from going on Rare, but there's too many of them. But the thing about this system was that there was so much quality gaming in this thing. It was a legendary gaming system, yeah. It had games like Super Mario 64, Donkey Kong 64, being the two 3D platformers which were really, really good on it. Super Mario 64 as being one of the finest 3D platformer on the system. Yeah, there was Paper Mario on there as well, which was quite good as well. Yeah, that was pretty good on there as well. There's quite good racing games, I would say. Obviously, they're really gone out of date now. Not really out of date, but they were really good, like 1080 Snowboarding, Extreme G, F0X, and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, Wave Race. It was all on there, good quality gaming, all that. So it's all really, really good stuff. Yeah. These are the older games now, you see, because if you look at the more advanced versions, the sequels to these games, they were far better. Not only they were better, they were one of the most amazing sequels ever made on the Nintendo GameCube, you know, these racing games, yeah. They were really, really good on it. Obviously, that Ridge Racer 64, obviously Ridge Racer 64 is just the same game on, which was the Ridge Racer DS, which was on Nintendo 64. It's just the same game on that, you see. They just released the same one on there. So there's nothing big on that side of things. So yeah, there's some good racing games. First-person shooters, yeah. The best one was like GoldenEye, I would say about that for shooters. Yeah. Fighting, what can you say about fighting games? I mean, there's an ironic characters one. Super Smash Brothers was quite a good one on there. Fighters Destiny 1 and 2 was really good. Yeah, there was some nifty fighting games on this machine. They're pretty good. I like Fighters Destiny quite a lot, actually. I don't know what other people thought about it, because like, it was a 3D fighting game, and it was really, really good, actually. Yeah, I thought it was really, really impressive in every way. There was, of course, there was another game, Mario Kart 64. That one was quite good as well. It's like more like based on the four-player, multiplayer stuff and that stuff in this game. Lilo Wars was really, really good on this thing. A very, very good game to reckon force with. So yeah, there you go. Number 2. Panasonic 3DO. 32-bit multiplayer system. Yeah. You're probably thinking, why did I choose that as number 2? There's a few reasons for that. This system is 32-bit, yeah? A CD-based games console on CDs. It had some incredible games, man. Pretty good ones. There were good stuff on this thing. They were quite enjoyable stuff. And they were pretty easy to play as well. They were pretty good. Okay. Now this system, you can play Panasonic video games, audio CDs, photo CDs, and with the adapter, you could play VCD movies on there. It was a pretty impressive system. If you look at all the lineup of machines, as I told you, it's the most advanced one with features, yeah. Really, really impressive. It's very, very good, man. Now, the games that this system had, Panasonic, one more Panasonic was, Burning Soldier was a really good shooter, man. Really good, man. Really, really good, man. It was a game that you want to look at a cockpit view. You're riding this kind of, I don't know what you call this kind of thing. Some kind of spaceship or something. And it's really, really good. This game was. The graphics are really good. The action is really good. It's a very, very amazing game to play from start to finish. Then there was another game called Iron Angel of the Apocalypse, which had incredible Japanese cutscenes. They were really, really impressive, man. I like this game a lot, man. Trust me, yeah, really, really good, man. He heard this guy, he goes, come to me, come to me, come to me. Saying stuff like that. Yeah, because you have to meet him in the tower and all that. It's a really, really impressive game. Then there was a sequel to it, the Iron Angel of the Apocalypse, something. The Return, something like that. That one is really good, man. It's really good. It's different to the first one, I would say. It was more advanced. The graphics looked better. The gameplay was more improved. The good thing about this game was that the enemy is more difficult. It was a more enjoyable game, I would say. Then there was a very quality version of Starblade. That was really, really good. A Namco shooter called Starblade. Starblade was one of them games that, you know, it was a quality game in every aspect. Really, really good. If you're looking for a really good Starblade game, he had a 3DO version. He had an arcade version, and a 3DO version was more enhanced. Yeah, it's really good. And then there was Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo. Very good version of this game on this system. Really good, man. I don't know what to say about it. Quite good. Super Street Fighter Turbo, obviously, is the of that version of the game. It was a much better version than the Sega Saturn PlayStation version. It looked really, really good. The animations were great. The fireballs were fluid. The fightings were epic. Musics were great. This game was everything what you wanted for. The quite a lot of the game, there was Way of the Warrior as well, which was a kind of good fighting game, I would say, as well. Then there was Primal Rage as well, with dinosaurs and all that, and stuff like that. And there was another game from Cyclone and Studio 3DO called Phoenix 3. That was one of the best games they made on there. Of course, Cyclone was involved in there. That was a really good. Like, it's giving you like this photorealistic a shooter, platforming action. A really good game. It's excellent stuff that was as well, yeah. So, yeah, Panasonic 3DO. A really, really good system. Now, for the final system. What can it be? Just after this. This is it, the final system of them all, the greatest games console with the greatest games ever developed. What can it be? Can you think what I'm thinking? Oh, you already know. Come on, Kuma, this is it. This is the machine you're on. Is it this machine? Capcom SKTO, the one on the Nintendo GameCube. Can it really be the Nintendo GameCube? Come on, boy. The final system. Number one. It is one and only Nintendo GameCube. Yes, Nintendo GameCube. Obviously, there's Nintendo GameCube and Panasonic Q games console. So, I am not putting Nintendo GameCube in there. We are going to be putting in this is a Panasonic Q games console, the one the images you see every time. This is the most amazing games consoles with features and games. Obviously, the Panasonic Q is a system, yeah? So basically, Nintendo made a deal with Panasonic to make this Nintendo GameCube games console, which was far superior than any games console you'll ever buy for your money. So the Panasonic Q was manufactured by Panasonic, which Panasonic gave you so much on this system. It was a very, very special system. First of all, it was in silver color. You had two handles to carry. Yeah. You had a beautiful display, which shows you the DVD / CD on there, and GameCube written on there as a text on there. And there was buttons below the display, and right at the front there was buttons on the left, buttons on the right. DVD drive, 4 game control ports. When you turn into a GameCube mode, you will see blue LED lights on these 4 game controller ports, you know. And front of there is a mirror faceplate. You either can see your face, you could see yourself in there, or you whatever you put front of there, like Panasonic game controller, Panasonic remote control, even the one you get with it, and any accessory, you will able to see that in front of the system. It's amazing. And at the back, there was phono sockets, subwoofer, S-video, DTS, and the digital AV out that you get on the original Nintendo GameCube. It's an amazing system. It's an amazing system. Yeah, so this system is one of the best one. And on top of that, Nintendo gave you Nintendo game exclusives. Yeah. There you go. So the games on this system are Luigi Mansion? Okay. Paper Mario? Super Mario Sunshine? Wario World. Top quality Nintendo platforming games. And then from Sonic Team, you got Sonic Adventure DX Director's Cut, Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, Sonic Heroes, Shadow the Hedgehog, Sonic Mega Collection, Sonic Gems Collection. This, it's a house of platformers, man, this system is. It's got the best platform games from Nintendo and Sonic Team. That's guaranteed, man. Sega didn't only just release these games, they also released Crazy Taxi, Sega Soccer Slam, Virtual Strikers, something 2002. Well, I think 2002 is a year or something like that, yeah. But they released stuff like that on there. And yeah, pretty interesting. And there's quite a lot of racing games on there. We got 1080 Snowboarding, technically superior version to Nintendo 64. These games are okay. So here we go, 1080 Snowboarding. Extreme G3, F-Zero GX, being one of the most stunning graphical, fastest racing game from Sega Nintendo, and one of the most amazing game you will ever play. There was that one. There's Mario Kart Double Dash, which is a features of Double Dash, where you got two people on the kart. Excellent feature, man. R-Racing Evolution. You will never ever get from further Nintendo machines a Ridge Racer game, yeah? There was a Wave Race as well on there. Okay, this Wave Race game was incredible. Giving you the best world effects you will ever see, yeah? So there was more, there was shooters as well, like Chaos Field, Ikaruga, Radeji, Metro Prime 1, Metro Prime 2 Echoes. Wow. Look at all these games, man. There's so many. Star Soldier. Who else was on the year? Time Splitters 2, Time Splitters Perfect. X3. Wow. Even the shooters on this system are epic. Nintendo GameCube has amazing these games. Also, it had, I don't know how to call this, because this game, like Metal Gear Solid, was a shooter. It was like a shooter where you can use first person view as well. First person view. It's adventuring as well, stealth. And it's using, you know, like a first-person shooter style as well from, you know, from Metal Gear Solid 2 Substance. It's got that in there as well. So, yeah, it's got all that stuff in there for you. So, it's pretty impressive, this game was. Yeah, I don't know if I'm missing anyone. Metal Gear Solid, yeah. There was that one as well. So, there's quite a lot of good stuff on this system, isn't it, really? Yeah, there was Star Wars Rogue Leader. Best Star Wars games on the GameCube, man. Star Wars Rogue Leader. And there was Star Wars Rebel Strike 3, yeah. That one was really, really good on it. So, yeah, there you have it. So, Panasonic Q has my vote as being the best games console or the most amazing games console on planet Earth. It has my vote as being the number one system for features and Nintendo game exclusives. You can't beat this thing, man. It's the number one system. So there you go. I hope you guys liked my video session today. Give your likes, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.